Hello students, so in this session we will discuss about the performance, processor clock, basic performance equation, clock rate and the performance measurement. So first we will see what is performance, okay. So here the most important measure of the performance of your computer, it is how quickly it can be execute the program. So here quick means speed, right? Speed. Okay, so this speed, it will be affected by three things. That is, the first one is the hardware. And the second one, it is the machine instructions, and the next one, it is the compiler. So here the compiler will convert the high level language into object code, right? So in the computer organization subject, we discuss only these two parts, hardware and the machine instructions. Here we are not touch the compiler part, okay. Here as a designer, he need to design the hardware, machine instructions and the compiler in a coordinated way, then only it will increase the performance of the computer. Here the performance of the computer, it will depends on the two times. In that, first one, it is the elapsed time and the processor time. What is the first one? It is elapsed time, and the second one, it is the processor time. Second one is processor time. Okay. So here, what do you mean by elapsed time? Elapsed time, it is the total time required to execute the one single program, right? So the next is the processor time. Processor time, that is nothing but how much amount of time your processor will be active, right? This is called processor time. So elapsed time is nothing but total time, right? Here you type the program, simple program, addition of two number program. Once you hit the run button, your elapsed time, it is start from hitting the run button till it will get the result in the monitor, right? It is called as elapsed time. So initially the program, you are typing the program and save the program. That same program, it is in the hard disk or secondary memory. So once you hit the run button to execute that program, that will be copied to main memory. Main memory to your processor will fetch the data from the main memory and execute it, and again it will store the result into the main memory and send the result to the monitor. These are the steps required to execute the program, right? So that whole time, it is called as elapsed time. So here it will involve the computer. It depends on all the units of the computer. But the processor time, how much time your processor will be active, right? That is called the processor time, right? So here it depends on only the hardware that will be involved to execute the one machine instructions. So it depends on the all units of the computer. All units of the computer. Right? All units of the computer. But the processor time, it depends on the hardware that will be involved to execute the one machine instructions, right? Here, hardware, it has nothing but the processor and the memory, right? Here, hardware is nothing but the processor and memory. Right, here how to connect the processor and memory? Here we are using the bus, right? bus is nothing but group of or bunch of lines, right? So by using that, we connect the processor and the main memory. To increase the performance of the computer, we need another one part we place inside the processor, that is called as cache memory, right? Okay. So here, hardware is nothing but processor and the memory, right? So yes, we will take the example here. So this is the bus, and this is your main memory. This is the main memory, and the second one is the processor. Processor, right? So we are connecting these two by using bus. So to increase the performance of the computer, we place the cache memory inside the processor. Here the cache memory, it is the smallest memory that is present inside the processor, right? So here, so always as I told in the earlier, so the program will be, once you save the program, that will be stored in the hard disk or secondary memory, right? So you need to execute that program, so that program will be copied to main memory. So your processor will fetch the data. Once initially the processor search the data in the cache memory. If the data is not present in the cache memory, it is called as cache miss. So what is we call as cache miss. So that means the data is not in the cache memory. So in that case, it will go to main memory and search the data and fetch the data and store it into the cache memory. Then it will execute it. In the second time, the processor need same data, it will find out in the cache memory. It will not search in the main memory. Okay. So here, yes, in the second time, the data is available in the cache memory. It is called as cache miss and cache hit. The data is present in the cache memory, and your processor will find out the data is present in the cache memory and fetch the data from the cache memory. It is called as cache hit, right? So here, so the communication between the main memory and the processor, it will be reduced. So once the communication between these two, it will be reduced, it will execute the program faster and faster. Then you will get the output very fast, right? So the main advantage of cache is it is very much nearer to the processor. So it will reduce the communication between the processor and the main memory time. Okay, so this is all about the performance. So here, performance, how to measure the performance? Speed. So in that, we have three things. So it depends, it will be affected by three things. One is hardware, machine instructions, and the compiler. So here, the designer need to design this in a coordinated way. So then here we have to increase the performance of the computer, we have main memory and the processor. Inside the processor, we put the cache memory. Okay, next we will see the second topic, processor clock. The processor circuit will be controlled by the timing intervals. So that time, it is called as the clock. The processor circuit, it will be controlled by the timing signals. That timing signals, it is called it as clock. So this clock will be divided into number of intervals. So that is called cycles per second. Okay. What is that? It is cycles. This clock will be divided into number of intervals. That intervals will be called it as cycles, right? Cycles. So cycles per seconds. Cycles, right? Say for example, so this is clock. Okay. This is the timing signal. So it contains, say for example, this is one clock cycle, this is one clock cycle, and this is one clock cycle. So always the machine instructions, it will be you need to execute the machine instructions, that will be divided into different number of basic steps, right? To execute one basic step, it will require one clock cycle. So within this clock cycle one basic step should be executed, right? So this is the clock cycles, right? So one up and down, this is called one cycle. So in this, it will contain three cycles, right? This is an example. So within this one cycle, it should execute one basic steps. So let P be the cycles, P be the clock cycles. So this P be the clock cycles. Let P be the clock cycles. Okay, so clock rate, how to calculate the clock rate? So to calculate, it is a clock rate is a inversely proportional to this P. So clock rate R, let R be the clock rate. So clock rate, it is inversely proportional to 1 by P, right? So here this clock rate will be measured in cycles per second. So 1 by P cycles per second. Okay, cycles per second. Okay, so next here you need to increase the value of R, you need to decrease the P value. You need to decrease the R, you need to increase the P value. So to give the better performance, you need to decrease the P value, you need to increase the R value. Clock rate should be high, so for that you need to decrease the P value. Here cycles per second, right? How to measure the clock rate? It is cycles per second. In the computer terminology, this cycles per second will be called as hertz. Hertz. Okay, this cycles per second will be called it as hertz. So in the modern computer and the workstations, it will be measured seconds. It will be executes millions and billions of cycles, right? Millions and billions of cycles per second. It will be completed millions and billions of cycles per second. Here millions, right? This is cycle per second. If it completes million cycles per second, then it is called it as megahertz, right? Megahertz. So it will complete billions per second, billion cycles per second. In the computer terminology, we call it as gigahertz. Megahertz and gigahertz. Say for example, so this is 500 millions per second, cycles, million cycles per second, right? 500 million cycles per second, right? How to write this in computer terminology? This will be written as million, right? 500 megahertz, right? So 500 megahertz. So can you calculate the clock rate for this? Yes. So R is equal to 1 by 500. So So to complete the execution of that particular machine instructions or that particular program, whole program, it will take 2 nanoseconds, right? This is the example. How to represent the 500 million cycles per second in computer terminology? Here it is 500 megahertz, and the clock rate is, it is R is equal to 1 by P. So P is 500, you will get 2 nanoseconds. To complete the execution of that program, it will require 2 nanoseconds. So take another one example. Another one example, say it is 1250 millions cycles per second. Okay, so this is 1250 million cycles per second. How to write this in computer terminology? It is 1.25. It is million, but it is in the thousand, right? It is billion. Billion, for billion, it is giga. Gigahertz. So calculate the clock rate for this. Yes, right? How? So this is R is equal to 1 by 1.25. Right? Giga means into 10 power 9. Mega means 10 power 6. Okay? So you'll get 0.8 nanoseconds. To complete that particular program, will be executed in within 0.8 nanoseconds. Okay, this is all about the processor clock. So what do you mean by clock? It is a timing signals. So the processor circuit will be controlled by this timing signal. It is called as clock. So for that clock will be divided into different intervals, that is called cycles. So here let P be the cycles per second. So how to calculate the clock rate? Clock rate, it is inversely proportional to the P, right? So R is equal to 1 by P. So in the computer terminology, million cycles per second will be called as hertz, and the million cycles per second, it is called as megahertz, and billion cycles per second, it is called as gigahertz. This is the example for that. Okay. Next, we will see the next topic. So that is basic performance equation. So the next topic is basic performance equation. Here we will take the processor time T. So the next topic is basic performance equation. T be the processor time. Okay, so here T be the processor time, and next is the N value. N is the number of machine instructions to execute the one particular program. It is the number of machine instructions. Okay. So next is the S value. S is the number of basic steps required to execute one instructions. Please note down this. S is the number of basic steps required to execute one machine instructions. It is number of basic steps required to execute one machine instructions, right? Here T be the processor time. So here this time, in this processor time, you will execute the one program, right? One program, that program will be written in the high level language, right? So to execute that high level language, we need T number of time, right? So next is the N. It is a number of machine, number of machine instructions to execute that particular program. Next is the S value. Here S is the number of basic steps. So the processor time is T is equal to N into S by R. R is the clock rate, right? R is the clock rate. Here this is called as the basic performance equation. So this is called as basic performance equation. Right, this is called basic performance equation. T is equal to N into S by R. So to increase the performance of the computer, you need to decrease the value of N, and S need to increase the value of R. How to increase the value of R? Always, so to increase the performance of the computer, need to decrease N and S value, and need to increase the R value. How to decrease or how to increase the R value? R is nothing but 1 by P. If you need to increase the, or you need to decrease the value of P, right? So R is equal to 1 by P. So you need to decrease the value of P, it will automatically increase the value of R, right? So, but here N is the number of machine instructions. So, to execute one particular program, so the computer will use fewer number of machine instructions, then it is automatically decrease the value of N. Next is S, right? S is the number of basic steps. Here the number of basic steps. So to execute the one machine instructions, it will take less number of basic steps. It is automatically decrease the S value, right? But R, it is decrease the P value, cycles per second, right? Cycles per second, P value, number of cycles will be reduced, then it is automatically increase the R value. So here N, S and R, it is interdependent. It is not independent parameters. It is dependent parameters. So if you change one value, it will affect other two parameters, right? So this is basic performance equation. Here we will study what is T, what is N, what is S, and basic performance equation, how to increase the performance of the computer. So need to decrease N and S value and increase the R value. So for that we need to decrease the P value, right? It is all interdependent, it is not independent parameters. Okay, so the next topic is clock rate. Okay, the next topic is clock rate. So to increase the clock rate, so clock rate is nothing but R, right? To increase the clock rate, so we have two possibilities. So the first one, it is the improving the IC technologies. So for that, from this, it will increase the R. So by improving the IC technology, the logical circuit will be faster. So if the logical circuit, it will be faster, then the number of basic steps required to execute the one machine instructions will be reduced. So from this, so the P value, cycles per second, it is also be reduced. So it will indirectly increases the clock rate, right? This is one possibility. And the second one, it will reduce the amount of processing done in one basic steps. That is nothing but it will decrease the value of P, right? So this is not easy, right? So we cannot easily, so here S, N and R value, it is interdependent, it is not independent parameter. So to achieve this, it is very difficult. So the next topic is performance measurement. Okay, the next topic is performance measurement. So the next topic is basic performance equation, sorry, perform, the next topic is performance measurement. So what do you mean by that performance measurement? It is very important to assess the performance of the computer. So different, as a designer, as a buyer, as a manufacturer, so measure the performance of the computer in different aspects. As a manufacturer, so the marketing purpose, they'll measure the performance of the computer. As a buyer, they'll compare different models of the computer to assess the performance of the computer. As a designer, the new features, they assess the performance of the computer to measure the performance of the new features. Okay, so here, So for that reason, the computer society, it will give the benchmark for us to assess the performance of the computer. What is that? It is benchmark. Okay. So here benchmark is nothing but it is a standardized program, right? It is a programs. Okay, it is a programs. So here initially this program, it is artificial program, and that artificial program will be executed in the computer to assess the performance of the computer. But in the later cases, spec is nothing but system performance equation corporation. Evaluation Corporation, System Performance Evaluation Corporation, it will give the benchmark suits. So set of benchmark suits, so it contains different programs, right? So that program, it will be ranges from the compiler, game playing programs, and different database application programs. This benchmark suits, it will contain different application programs, right? So how to find the spec rating? What do you mean by that spec rating? So here the program will be run in the reference computer and in the testing computer and find out the spec rating. Say for example, spec rating may be 50. That means your testing computer, it will be 50 times faster than the reference computer. So how to find out the spec rating? It is the running time for the reference computer divided by running time of the computer under test. So we have n number of programs in the benchmark suits. In 1987, the first benchmark suit will be published. In 1995, the second benchmark suits will be published. And in the 2000, the last benchmark suit will be published. Okay, so this is the spec rating. It is for only one program. Right, so for n programs will be executed in both reference as well as in the computer under test. So for that we have formula called spec rating for n program. So n program is equal to I is equal to 1 to n, it is a spec of I whole to the power 1 by n. So this is spec rating for n programs. This is all about the performance measurement. Thank you.